students in India.
I think it's really important to catch kids early in life and tell them about, you know, about different professions, about, you know, journeys, about, and then I think people from all walks of life are here. So I think kudos to the people who have put this together, Capital. The Varsaloo wala part, man. Okay, so kudos to the people who have put this together, Even Capital. I think edutainment is genuinely a different concept where education and entertainment comes together on one platform and makes people, especially kids who are from school and college, understand what path of life they want to choose.
Okay, इसी के साथ में जब स्टूडेंट्स से मिलते हैं, जब ऐसे किसी सेमिनार्स को अटेंड करते हैं, जब जर्नी शेयर करने का जब मौका मिलता है, टाइम मिलता है, तो कुछ आपको आपके कॉलेज की कुछ मेमोरीज की जैसे याद आती हैं?
I have been a part of a lot of events where I've sat in the audience and, you know, and I've heard people talk from OP Nayyar sir to Shah Rukh sir. And I think it's always quite gratifying and to come here and be a part of the panel and talk on the stage and not be a part of the kids in the audience. It's such a... I think God has been very kind, and I think you have to be really blessed to take that shift. And yeah, I enjoyed my session. I hope kids enjoyed my session.
Okay, but इसी के साथ में किस तरीके से देखते हैं सारी जर्नी को ऑडियंस से स्टेज पे आने तक की,
जैसे यार as I said, you only have to be blessed to have such a journey. A lot of people dream to do a lot of things in life, but sometimes they don't, you know, get fulfilled. I think we all here are blessed ones in case apne genuinely pure hue hain, and we are genuinely living a dream, you know. Especially if you talk about me, I never thought 10 years back that this is going to happen, you know, in life. And if anyone can learn from that journey, I mean, I'll be more than grateful to the God that I've been able to help someone to crack it. But having said that, I think everyone, each one of us anywhere in the world will have their own journey. You can only learn to get the reality checks right.
Okay, aapke hisab se India mein education kitni zarurat hai aur education jo system hai,
kya main bola sun paya tum bol rahe ho, aapke hisab se kya
hai? Sorry, come again.
India mein education,
ek minute, unko bhi aane do, aane do, unko bhi aane do, aise nahi kar,
acha aaram
se,
koi nahi, koi sab kuch nahi, tension nahi hai, tension zindagi achhi hai, chalo दोबारा से ले लेंगे, दोबारा से ले लेते हैं सर, आप टेंशन मत लो। यार आई थिंक एजुकेशन तो यार किसी भी अंडर डेवलप्ड कंट्री में जरूरत है, हम तो फिर भी डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज हैं, कहीं पे पूरे वर्ल्ड वाइड जहाँ पे भी आपको लगता है कि एजुकेशन सही तरीके से नहीं पहुँच रही है, वहाँ पे पहुँचनी जरूरी है। हैविंग सेड दैट, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट आवर कंट्री, आई थिंक पिछले कुछ टाइम में हमने कुछ मेजर्स जरूर लिए हैं, लेकिन हैविंग सेड दैट, जो ग्रास रूट लेवल पे अभी चीज़ें मुझे लगता है थोड़ी सी ठीक करनी ज़रूरी हैं। एंड एजुकेशन विल ऑलवेज बी द मेजर पार्ट ऑफ, यू नो, अपब्रिंगिंग फॉर एनीवन। यू नो, अगर आप एक सिविलाइज सिटीजन ऑफ द कंट्री बनना चाहते हैं, आपको हमेशा एजुकेशन ही आधी चीज़ें सिखाएगा, रादर जो हम इतनी सारी मुहिम छेड़ते रहते हैं वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट को लेकर, यू नो, सेफ वुमेन सेफ्टी को लेकर। आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द एजुकेशन सिस्टम। जब आप अच्छी तरह एजुकेटेड होते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं आपको ज़्यादा आइडिया होता है कि आपने सबको इक्वली कैसे ट्रीट करना है, आपको, यू नो, किसको कैसे, हर एक को कैसे इक्वल रिस्पेक्ट देनी है। सो आई थिंक वो एजुकेशन पार्ट का ही सिस्टम है, एजुकेशन सिस्टम का ही पार्ट है। सो एजुकेशन इज एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट।
और ये भी कहना चाहूँगा कि एडुटेनमेंट, यू नो, शो है, तो क्या कहना चाहेंगे आज के दौर में जो भी फिल्में बन रही हैं, एंटरटेनमेंट प्लस एडुकेशन, ये दो फैक्टर कितना ज़्यादा आप देख रहे हैं कि इन्वॉल्व है एक फिल्म में?
देखो, ऑफकोर्स फिल्में हमें बहुत कुछ सिखाती हैं, फिल्में हमें ऑफकोर्स बहुत ज़्यादा प्रेरित भी करती हैं। मुझे भी बचपन से काफ़ी फिल्मों ने प्रेरित किया, लेकिन मैं इस पॉइंट पे ना ये ज़रूर कहना चाहता हूँ कि कई बार ऐसा हो जाता है कि लोग कहते हैं कि यार फिल्म में ये ऐसा कैसे दिखा सकते हैं, इससे तो गलत भावना, यू नो, लोगों के दिल में आएगी। कई लोग, और कई बार तो बहुत ज़्यादा प्रोटेस्ट भी हो जाते हैं। यार एक फिल्म ना किसी की, मतलब इतना प्रेरित नहीं कर सकती, आप खुद अपना रियलिटी चेक आपके दिमाग में होता है। अदरवाइज तो हम सबने गैंग्स ऑफ वसीपुर देखी है, हम सब तो नहीं बन गए, मतलब बंदूक में हाथ लेकर नहीं खड़े हो गए शहर में। सो हर एक को अपना रियलिटी चेक अपनी समझ खुद होती है कि फिल्म को देखने के बाद व्हाट यू हैव टू टेक होम व्हाट यू डोंट हैव टू टेक होम. सो हैविंग सेड दैट आई मीन देयर फिल्म्स व्हिच आर मेड फॉर सच मैसेजेस देयर फिल्म्स व्हिच आर नॉट मेड फॉर सच मैसेजेस वी नीड टू रिस्पेक्ट बोथ द फिल्म्स इक्वली. बाकी रही बात यू नो परसेप्शन की कि इस तरह से आपने उसको सीखना है क्या क्या आपने घर लेके जाना है वो टोटली आपके ऊपर है.
ओके पर उसी के साथ में जिस तरीके से आपने बोला कि फिल्में बहुत ज़्यादा प्रेरित भी करती हैं
जी
वो तो मतलब ऐसी कोई फिल्म है जिसने आपको बहुत ज़्यादा प्रेरित किया हो?
यार अभी मैं जैसे स्टेज पे भी कह रहा था कि आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन अ स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन इन लाइफ एंड आई फंक्शन लाइक वन इवन टुडे. तो बचपन से अब तक मुझे जो जीता हुई सिकंदर ने बहुत ज़्यादा इंस्पायर किया है. वो फिल्म स्पोर्ट्स के ऊपर थी, वो फिल्म में भाइयों का प्यार दिखाया हुआ था वहाँ पे, यू नो स्कूल कॉलेज स्कूल हॉस्टल्स दिखाए हुए थे. तो आई थिंक एक कंप्लीट पैकेज था. इतने अच्छे गाने थे उस फिल्म में, यू नो डांस ऑफ हो रहा है और कितना कुछ हो रहा था. आई थिंक एक कंप्लीट वर्ल्ड था वो. एंड ऑफ कोर्स आमिर सर बीइंग आमिर सर इज ऑलवेज बीन अ पार्ट ऑफ कल्ट फिल्म्स.
ओके इसी के साथ में व्हाट इज द स्टेटस ऑफ सुपर डांसर?
यार स्ट्रीट डांसर, यार स्ट्रीट डांसर बस अब क्लाइमेक्स शूट करना बाकी है. बाकी सब टच वुड अच्छा शूट हो गया है. फिल्म में तकरीबन 12 गाने हैं एंड मज़ा आ रहा है. फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव बीन अ पार्ट ऑफ यू नो रेमोस फिल्म एंड ही इज़ जेन्युइनली अ टीम पर्सन. सबको एक साथ खाना और यू नो एंड यू नो बिकॉज देर इतने सारे डांसर्स होते हैं शूट पे तो एनर्जी हमेशा अप टेम्पो रहती है एंड रियली हैप्पी दैट आई हैव बीन अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस जर्नी.
एक लास्ट क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहूंगी कि जावेद अख्तर ने अभी रिसेंटली कहा है कि बुर्का बैन होने के साथ साथ घूंघट को भी बैन होना हटाना चाहिए तो जिस पे करणी सेना ने उनको धमकी दी है कि अगर वो माफी नहीं मांग रहे तो उनको घर में से मांगे तो आप बॉलीवुड का एक हिस्सा है तो आप किस तरह से देखते हैं कि हर बार वो बॉलीवुड के लोगों को इस तरह से धमकी देते हैं?
देखिए पहली बात तो मैंने अभी बाय चांस की बात है मैं ट्रैवल कर रहा था और मैंने ये किस्सा नहीं पढ़ा है तो मुझे आई डोंट हैव द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द यू नो एंटायर इंसिडेंट सो आई डोंट रियली वांट टू कमेंट ऑन दैट. अगर ऐसा कुछ सिचुएशन अराइज हुई है सो ऐसा ज़रूरी नहीं है कि जस्ट बिकॉज आई एम एन एक्टर मुझे इस बारे में कहना ज़रूरी है कि मैं क्या सही है क्या गलत. स्पेशली व्हेन आई डोंट नो द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द केस आई थिंक इट विल बी नॉट राइट टू कमेंट. थैंक यू.
Everybody wants to keep them happy. So as a writer, you realize that no, as an actor, I only have that much part to play in the story, and then and others have much more to do in the story. And similarly, as a writer, it helps if you are an actor, then you know what an actor goes through, what are the beats of an actor. So that really helps. It helps you understand the process of one thing is to conceive a scene and write it and write the dialogue and the screenplay of it. And one thing is to understand how achievable it is by an actor or by a director in some cases. So in that sense, it definitely helps you. Which job satisfies you more? Acting, writing, creating? Pick one.
Acting.
सबसे कम काम उसमें ज्यादा पैसा भी उसमें है तो इट्स वेरी नाइस.
सो वी नो व्हाट एवरीवन इज थिंकिंग अबाउट राइट नाउ. ओके थैंक यू सो मच. वी कम बैक टू यू गुरमीत. दो busy directing two of the biggest shows on the digital space currently in the last 2-3 years. I don't think you've left a set or an edit room in the last 2 years. A lot of you know young minds here, people who want to be in this business, and a lot of young people on set always, right? So what's a good place to start? What's a good job or position?
I guess the magic always happens once the camera is rolling and once you're on set. So that kind of energy you'll not get anywhere else in the filmmaking process. So just being part of you know that whole process, being there as it's being made, gives you that experience, that knowledge that no other part of this process can. So obviously it depends on the individual if they know what are their likes and dislikes and how aware they are of it. If you know you have a bent towards creating things, you have the art department you're going to. If you think you're a storyteller, there's always the writing process, directing. If you feel like you are a performer, you want people to watch you, you obviously want to get into it as an actor. So I think if you're just starting off and you want to get an experience of the world, anywhere is great. And there'll be so much to see, so much to watch, so much to enjoy, because I think I really value every moment that we get to be on set. And no matter how tough it is, it's draining, it's exhausting, but every time you finish a shoot day, it's like, that's really
satisfying.
Yeah, so just being on set is great. So when you're not to get into this line, just jump into it, whatever you're getting, go there, enjoy yourself, keep your eyes and ears open, and you'll be rewarded in a way you don't know.
Yeah, that's true. On every set we always work with a lot of young people who are working, for the first time on a set, etc. What's the best part about that experience? What kind of energy do you draw from?
I think, a film set has, from 50 to 200 people working at the same time. When you have so many people, each one brings something to the table. So just being there and absorbing everyone's energies, everyone's knowledge, everyone's expertise, I guess that just makes you richer as a professional and as a person. So, and again, it's very difficult to quantify what you learn every day on the set, but somehow it's enriching you. Obviously, your craft grows the more you work at it, because it's not so much a knowledge-driven medium. You have certain skill set that you need to learn, but beyond that, it's about your life experiences. It's about your working every day that makes you better, makes you more comfortable with your craft, that can help you push boundaries. So I guess it's just the interaction with various people that you have, and they'll be, good, bad, angry, sweet, everything. You will get a variety of people and emotions every day, on set.
Yeah, you get to learn a lot, right? You get to learn a lot from
meeting. Absolutely. You just being there educates you, many points. Yeah.
Yeah. So Shantanu, has been writing web series for many years, and also wrote a smash hit film, Badai Ho, which was a big in 2018. You're collaborating a lot with younger writers. You're working in rooms where there are writers who are either starting their journey or are somewhere a couple of years in whatever. Why do you like to collaborate with younger people, with fresher minds?
Over the last 8 months, I've written 3 films, out of which two I've collaborated with first-time writers. And the reason why I would want to collaborate with younger, newer writers is because it matters to them what happens to that film or that show. Unko ye stress nahi hai, unko tension hoti hai agar ek scene kaam nahi karta. So when they sense that this show, this scene, this story is not making sense, it gives them sleepless nights.
And that's a good thing.
And as creators, as storytellers, you should be scared if something doesn't work. And you can only make a difference in this world if it matters to you. अगर आपको फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा ना कि मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ फिल्में बनाने के लिए शोज बनाने के लिए या एक्टिंग करने के लिए या डायरेक्ट करने के लिए अगर आपको फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा तो आप रहने दें मत करो कुछ और करो द डे यू सेंस दैट व्हाट आई एम राइटिंग व्हाट आई एम क्रिएटिंग इज गोइंग टू मेक अ डिफरेंस इफ इट डजंट हैपन it will not let me sleep. That's the night, that's the day when you decide hey, this is the line of work for me. And that's the reason why I collaborate with younger people, people who are just starting their journey. Because everything is new for them, they're hungry, it matters to them. And I think that's the way we all should be on our careers.
There's a big, we all know where there are about 80 to 100, series, digital series being released these days, and there's a big boom. There's a lot of opportunity.
opportunity. So at this point in time, what would your advice be to anybody here or out there who wants to start writing?
My writing advice is usually just two words. One is awareness, the other one is application. Awareness is consume as much as you can. An application is try to apply what you've learned through your research, through your consumption, into a story. That's it. And your home.
Rajshree is a very interesting combination. I've only got to know about her last week when we were talking about this panel. She's an actor and an activist. She works equally hard at her craft as well as, you know, working with humanitarian causes, etc. It doesn't happen very often. Also, her movie and digital choices pretty much reflect her philosophy. What would your advice be, you know, to this audience about finding a voice, you know, finding...
Hi. How are you doing, Mom? Good? Thank you so much, and I'm really happy to be here with the amazing people. I think I should be here and listen to all of them, but yeah. So as you said, actor and activist. So I don't know about activist. I don't know what is the term called activist. There are people, they call me environmentalist, and there are people who call me humanitarian. There are people who call, there are many names for, you know, basically standing up for yourself. There are names, which I think should not be there, because we all should and we all stand up for some other things, right? Fine, as an actor, it's my passion, it's my love. But as activist, humanitarian, environmentalist, it's part of me being a human, you know? I'm a human being first, and that's my responsibility, and it's everyone's responsibility. And I think maybe what I'm doing with like farmers or people or whatever, it's there somewhere, but we all do some other things. We talk to each other properly, we treat people properly. That's actually being an activist. You're standing up for yourself. If something happened to the other girl, she will stand up for you, you know? That's, she will be called as activist. So, that's what I do in my real life, and being an actor, so I don't know what I became first, activist or actor, but since my childhood, there are n number of things happened in my life. So I of course started with being a mimicry artist at age 5, dancer at age 5 only, and activist is because maybe I have seen people around me, my mother, how she has dealt with situations, and that's what taught me that you need to be a good person, you need to understand everything and behave in a certain way, or behave, understand the basic human issues and problems and about the society. And that's why I'm an actor and activist. And being about the roles, so you know, doing something like I hardly do a sanitary pad ads. I say no to them because I know in the rural market that something doesn't work. So if you want to launch something in a rural market, which is completely no-no, because the kind of a temperature which is there is 45 degrees up. So you can't sell plastic, and there is nothing like biodegradable. Trust me, I have to work in that. So that's my responsibility as a human being. So being an artist also is my responsibility what I'm selling. When we say that fair and lovely, of course it's wrong. So you give me whatever money, I will not do it. There are so many things I say no because I know that this is completely wrong. So as I see those things as a human being first, a forget activist or whatever it is, but I know it's completely wrong. So that's where I take a call.
Interesting. I think I don't know too many people who, a small percentage, but I think it's a great idea for artists, especially in front of the camera, they reveal a lot more power to make these choices. Thank you for the answer. Aparna, you know, heads content at Z5. They're rolling out, if not more, 75 shows in a year, right? That's a lot of content to make, buy, sell, create and curate, right? You meet, you know, what